Let's talk about the game itself, because there's been a lot of conversation. In particular, an interview that Hex did on his Eavesdrop podcast with Scump about modern warfare, about fines, about certain people getting reprimanded for certain things that they say on video. I found it, Emily, very interesting that, and we were talking about this a little bit off camera, that Scump basically revealed that he was fined for a video that they did where they were ranking the different Call of Duty titles, and he just trashed Modern Warfare. You've had a lot of opinions on this and Infinity Ward, etc. But what do you make of Scump in particular voicing his opinion in this way?
I mean, I feel like it's not an opinion that like everyone else doesn't have, and people shouldn't be shocked that Scump rated it so low, because there are a lot of pros, I would say the vast majority, who just do not enjoy playing Modern Warfare at all. And additionally, due to, again, like, I know I keep bringing this up like every single show, but because Infinity Ward is so stubborn about not, like, not even stubborn, they just like do not care about competitive. I can see like why, especially progressively as the season goes on, with everything else that's happened, with the pandemic, with people having to play online, like, it is frustrating. And I'd say that I'm surprised that Scump didn't voice his frustrations, like, sooner. But I guess he's not as, like, not as bombastic on social media as some other players. So, but I don't know. It shouldn't come as a surprise to anyone. Like, Modern Warfare, if I was a competitive player, there are so many things about this game. There's so many things that have happened at, like, every single event, that I would just be having like controller throwing across the room, like gamer moments. Like, it is just seems like so frustrating, and at times so unfun to play this game due to things that are like completely out of your control. Like, I think the spawn thing was a breaking point for a lot of people who hadn't necessarily come out and been as critical of the game itself. Like, changing the spawns without telling people twice, probably more times, but like twice in recent weeks, right? So like, it's just like, I don't know, like, I understand, you know, I don't understand, because I'm not a competitive player, but like, I can sympathize with their frustration, because it's not like things are gonna get better until there's a new COD, right? So I think everyone at this point is kind of just looking forward and being like, okay, Treyarch, please save us from another year of this kind of lack of communication between the developer and the competitive community.
And that's what's, and Scum mentioned that in the interview as well. He's looking forward to Treyarch taking over because of the communication there, of course. But also, he did say that, he did go so far as to say that Modern Warfare is the worst COD ever made and Warzone saved it. He did say that, and it's very easy to guess, whether you see comments on Twitter or not, that this is not the only person that has this sentiment. Scump being, like, I think that this is definitely an overwhelming sentiment among many of the pros, and it's interesting that we usually around this time of year, we get new announcements about the next Call of Duty League title. Of course, we're in a pandemic. Things have been shifted. We've seen that with many other titles. Look at Cyberpunk, perfect example. But
yep.
I wonder if what, like in terms of this game,
are you threatening us with another year of Modern Warfare?
No.
That. My heart can't handle that. I thought you were going to imply that, like, we're not going to get another game. I'm like, Arda, no.
That just cannot happen. That would be the worst. Can you imagine? Like, no.
I think we see a lot of retirements and then people coming back a year later.
See, that's the other thing. Remember, we were talking about this a couple weeks ago where, like, yeah, Karma retired, but like, even Scump said, you know, he retired for this season. Like, look what happens when Treyarch returns and that communication returns and the competitive players feel like they have a stake and they feel like they have a proper rapport with the developer where things are getting changed the way they like it. Like, I don't feel like these... I will believe it when, if and when Karma stays retired at that point.
I think it'd be great if Karma came back just because of the player he is, right? Like, it was sad to see that he retired, especially given how just like tired he seemed of playing the game. But he did mention it wasn't just this, you know, it wasn't just this Modern Warfare. Modern Warfare was kind of the final straw, and he had said that he hadn't enjoyed playing COD for a little while. So I'm like undecided, because sometimes you can, you know, just be like, okay, I'm so tired, and on top of this, this game is terrible, and therefore I do not want to play it anymore, so I'm retiring, and then, you know, minds can change. But I don't know. I mean, he has a family. He has other stuff going on. Like, maybe he'll return. I can see why Modern Warfare would definitely be a catalyst for retirement, though.
Yeah, no kidding. Like Scump said, well, here's where we'll leave it. Hopefully there is no delay and we do get information soon.
Oh, please.
For the benefit of everyone.
During the entire PlayStation thing, you and I were just like, Call of Duty, Call of Duty, come on, give it to us. And they didn't.
They did not. It was very sad. We were just sitting there like, and no, nothing.
No. Yeah.